Okay.
How else? Yes, Bhagavad Gita. I think in Eilam Lucha, Eilam Hazak, Eilam Haba, Shnagachim Chayal Choyel, Yer Alikim Tzion, Al Chacham Tzadik. There's constantly an Aliyah. Eilam Lucha. There's no Menucha. There's constantly an Aliyah. Aliyah is about whoever writes in Tanya as the Kodesh after the Stalkus, Ravenna Vitebska, the Bechai Atzadik, if in a Chai Psorim, the life of Atzadik, not the physical life of Atzadik, the life of Atzadik is a Luna of the year. What's the real life? What's the yichya of a person? What gives a person chiyus, life? The real life of a person is not what they eat, not what they sleep, the body that they have. The real life of a person is the emuna, the avva, the yira. When a person is begashli, so physically in a body, so then there's the smashtus of the oyer of the tzaddik. It's about that there's the tzaddik. The smashtus of the oyer of the tzaddik that surrounds a person, it's back of the person. This is why Dalai Lama's kind of split. Dalai Lama's the person is, Dalai Lama's is, the person is with the size of a human being, he lies down. So, and Allah, the gather of Dal Davas is that it's that's the person's Shayachid. That's the limit of that idea. And a person's Dal Davas, the person's Mispash, the person expresses himself and his surrounding, this is really his Shayachid. That's why if you carry Dal Davas and Shusarabi and Shabbos, what's one? Because it's so Shus. You might see you're taking out from your Shayachid to another Shusarabi. Which means that a person is mispashit in the Dalai Lama's. This is what happens even during life. Even during a person's life. This is the reason why a person sometimes you feel connected. Maria Kaddish writes, Ramana writes. Sometimes you're sitting in the presence of somebody, and even if the person is not speaking, but you feel the oil of the person, because that's their makifim, that's where a person's oil is, his passion. So you're feeling the ruach of the person, the oil of the person. It's like a contagious. But then when a person passes on, leaves the room, leaves the body, so then that oil is no longer just a spashit and it all happens. That's a smash that in there. It's oil ruchni. It's oil ruchni. It would have had the years oil ruchni. It's a spiritual thing. It's not a physical thing. And therefore, the smash of this oil ruchni is everywhere. And a person could be a kabbal and scash himself with this oil. And even the people of the north to actually see or be present. Then there's an idea that it gets even deeper every year. There's a yatim chayev that it increases. Talmid b'chom eilu lucha. That there's an aliyah of the tzaddik. If there's an aliyah of the tzaddik, then there's an aliyah to everyone that's miskasha to the tzaddik. And here's the, what does it mean that eilu lucha leibu eilu haza. So, the Pashtus and Elam Haza in this world, where it's a world of So the nature of the creation, the way they created the world, was that everything has a... So there's a talich, there's a process. This is a poisoner. It's a way station. It's a place to get to. So you're moving, and it's a place of tenua, a movement. So that's why Yechum Chayel Choyel by Elam Hazah makes sense. You're constantly growing, you're constantly shoyif, you're learning new things, you're understanding new things, you're doing more mitzvahs. It's an alicha. But Elam Hazah is the schar. The schar is the tachlis, it's the end. So what's a shot? That is tenua in the tachlis. Happy tenua in the tachlis. Like you know, you say that the Moisachal. And the Moisachal is the Talich of Tnua, movement. Then comes Shabbos. What Shabbos? Shabbos is Tach Shemaim Orz, Mechula Shemaim Kloyer. So what's Madega Shabbos? Madega Shabbos is Bilti Tnua. Shabbos is no tenu, there's no movement. Shabbos is ayetzi shemun koymoi. Why ayetzi shemun koymoi? Because there is no place to go. That's the war. Ayetzi shemun koymoi means you have to go out of your lakim. And Shabbos is the lakim itself. There's no even before pnimius. Is this the shalosh shagolim is regal. Regal is a hiluch. That's why Shalosh Shagolim is a mitzvah of to be oiler regel. Shat oiler regel is that your mila elevate the choil into regel, and there's a tenu of hiluch that's considered the base of English. This is one tenu. Shabbos, what Shabbos? Shabbos is the oil that comes down. Not that we elevate ourselves, which is a hiluch regel, that we have to be oiler regel, we have to be oiler to mitzvah. To makabel the kedushas ayantiv, Shabbos and kachar kaimer, the kedushas Shabbos comes down. The kedushas about Shabbos comes down. The yitzish kaimer, there's no place to go because there's no movement, there's no tenua. That's what Shabbos is. So what's pshat? Midachom elu luchah loy peil mahaza, loy peil mahab. The whole idea of peil mahab is the opposite of tenua. That's the sky, that's the tachlis. So the Rebbe spoke about this Gemara. The oasis of there is something to do that even in the place of Elam Haba, which is the idea of Shabbos. Yeah. There's no tenua. There can be a tenua from a place of e tenua. What does this mean? What the law explains us? There's two mahalach. It's two part. It's two madrigas. Just two. Two ways. The Moshel that Hashem told us brings down this Moshel. Hashem is rapping. Hashem, are you? But there was once a king, and the king wanted to know whether his subjects are loyal to him. He wants to figure out if his subjects are loyal. He takes one of his trusted ministers and tells his trusted minister, you should go and dress yourself differently so no one knows that you're one of my ministers. And you should try to stir up a rebellion against the kingdom. And like this, you'll see if people are for me or against me. So he goes. He comes to the first city. And he starts talking that, you know, the king is not a good king. And we should really rebel against the king. And the people are listening and say, Taka, you know, the king is not a good king. Okay. We're going to start a rebellion. Then he goes to the second city. And he comes and says, the king is not a good king. They say, what do you mean? We like the king. The king was a good king.
Comes to the second king, second, and they say, what do you mean the king is a good king? And they throw the guy out of the city. The minister comes to the third town, and he starts stirring up a rebellion against the king. And the townspeople say, first of all, we like the king. Second of all, aren't you the minister? Don't you? What's wrong? Baal Shem said, this is be'erech, the way a person has a struggle with his Yetzirah. One person believes his Yetzirah, and Taka Nebuch struggles against the king. The second group, the minister comes, the Yetzirah comes, and they say, no. We don't want to listen to you, and we drive the Yetzirah away. But the third city, what does the third town come along and say? Third town comes along and says, you work for the king. We know who you are. That's Shat. Shat is the recognition that the Yetzirah, who created the Yetzirah? Maybe she created the Yetzirah. Yetzirah is Moshe Zoyna, the Zoyna says, the Yetzirah is Hashem's minister. And his job is to tempt you. And your job is not to listen to him. And to recognize that he's only there to tempt you. It's not a real Messias. It's not like you have this one side of you that's really a good side. That's your Yetzer Tov. Then there's a little devil, little bad guy that lives in you. And Mamish, this is who you are. No. You are a Chelek L'Kavim Mal Mamish. That's who you are. You have a Yetzirah. That's part of the game. The Eibush created the Yetzirah. So what should you do with this Yetzirah? You should explain the Yetzirah that I know you're working for. We're working for the same team, so stop bothering me. That's it. And then you win without a fight. You win without a fight. So this is the Oymik of a type of tenua for a place of Shabbos, a place of lemaila min ha'tenua. Yemei Sachol, the days of the week, represents the place of struggle, of strife. They have Tizra, Karmecha, the days that we have to work and toil the land. The days of the weekday. Shabbos is a Shalom Yaseir. Shabbos is a Komalach Ha'asuya. Shabbos is the day of Shlemus. Mal Shabbos Bo Menucha. Ein Ha'ayim Shalem. Achibo Shabbos. Shabbos is the idea of Shlemus. Shlemus is the Nefesh Adam. Is what is Shabbos saying? Ayetzish Mekoimai. You don't have to go anywhere. You don't have to be shy for anything that's different. Kilu Komalach Ha'asuya means not only that you have to imagine Komalach Ha'asuya Begashmias, but also Beruchnias, that the Madrega that you're supposed to reach, you reached. That's the Madrega of Shabbos. That's the Madrega of Elam Haba. Tzadikim Elam Benucha Loi Be'Elam Haza, Loi Be'Elam Haba, that from a place of Elam Haba, of the Nekuda, of Shabbos, of Elam Haba, Bein Elam Haba, in a person's life. From there, you also have to be shoyef, to have desire, to learn, to yearn, and to long, and to grow. But it's a very different type of shifas. It's a very different type of desires, because your desire is coming from a place that you're already whole to begin with. That you already reached the tachlis. You're already in the ulam haba. Why do you have to work? Because that's what the Hashem wants. Hashem wants to work, to hard, to strive. But it's with recognizing that the Yitzhahara is not, you know, we're not schizophrenic people. It's not like we have a dual personalities, and one day you're a good person, one day you're not, and one day you're tzaddik, one day you're rasha. No, you're a tzaddik that falls. Shevi yivul tzaddik will come. This is the madrega we're on. Amach kulam tzaddikim. This is the oil really that was revealed by the Baal Shem. The new oil that came down to this world. Moshe v'siyamim is connected to Mashiach, to the Geula, to Yechidish of Nefesh. The oil that was revealed in Torah Sachsidus, which is a new oil that came into the world, a new light that came into this world. This oil was very much revealed in a very, well, like a practical, gashmistic level. Was revealed by the Rebbe. That there was a revealing of this oir, a continuous revealing of this oir, the oir of Shleimus. That in the Olam HaGashmi, the physical world, there's a way to understand this oir, this revealing of this Shleimus and the Sitkus on a very ruchnistic level, an avoidedic level. Avoided means that you reach the Madrega of Shleimus and that you're the Tachlis. And then there's also in a very practical Olam Hazadik way to understand this. Because once speaking to a group of, let's just say, not yet from Eden, from Brazil. Those are other people, and they want to know if they should leave Brazil, not leave Brazil. Whatever, it's a tach. It's like a gosh, it's like a shayla. There's economies and issues. So there's an interesting idea, a thought that goes through in a lot of the teachings of the Rebbe and the Rabbi Noah Ross, what the Rebbe spoke about, is that, for example, so there's a whole Indian of Shtachim, whether you give up land for peace. The Rebbe was very against it. And a lot of people think that this is an argument for Shleimus Aras has to do with like a Ruchnistic argument. I'm not saying it's not. But mainly the Rebbe focused on the Din Shulchan Aruch, Shilchaz, and it's a Kodesh Nefashos. But the same tomorrow, when Eden turned to apartheid after the fall of the apartheid in South Africa, when people asked the Rebbe if they should leave South Africa, they were told no. When Crown Heights was turning, Crown Heights used to be a very full trade neighborhood for other different horizons as well. A lot of Rebbe's in Crown Heights. And when the neighborhood was turning, the Rebbe didn't let anyone leave. Anyone asked them to stay. I think that the Oymek, all those things are connected. It's not that it's all as this as of course it's all as this as the Shaila is when you look at yourself and you're in a place. You're in a physical place. My Shem Kanana, Shem Tzadi Govik Kanana, maybe should put you in this place. I'll tell you a personal story. Many years ago, maybe 15, 20 years ago, we moved to a very secular neighborhood here in Brooklyn, near Park Slope. Came Sukkos. I was a younger man. And Sukkos, what I remember Sukkos is that Sukkos, by night, Chalamoy, Yifabrei. It's in the Sukkot, Yifabrei. So when I was a bacher, my Zaidi used to ring Rav Amayar. My Zaidi was no longer alive. But my wife's grandfather was Rabbi Yossel Weinberg. Some people know him. He wrote the Lessons in Tanya, Shimon Sefer Tanya, the Alder Chassid. So I said, you know, maybe that's what I said. You should come for bring. I'm going to bring secular Jews in my sukkah in the backyard, and we're going to for bring as if it's Flatbush, Brown Heights. A kitzer. I thought this is normal, right? This is what you do. So it's your fabrega. So it's the neighborhood is a very to say it's a very liberal neighborhood. Police started coming, sirens. It was tremendous. Agastafish. I didn't understand what's going on with fabrega. Saha, we're singing the gula in the backyard. Marash. Hey, we're a little louder than the neighbors, no. But we weren't doing anything. You know, what are we doing? Sitting and singing in Gulim, learning a little Torah. And at the end, like at some point in the night, late, they close us down. They said, listen, forget it, Rabbi, you can't continue this. This is the Shemitah. So it's going to be a Chil Hashem. Okay, forget it. This, you know. And the next day, I had a big Nechilas HaRuach because most of the people that lived on the block are Taki Eden, secular Eden. And I felt like, what am I doing here? What's felt Merois? I'm here ruining the neighborhood, starting to bring by night. Maybe I should Taki, we get out of here. Like, what's. And also the way people were looking at me, they used to look at me very nice, but now they're looking at me like, oh, here goes the neighborhood. And I had this machshava, and I was thinking, then I realized, Marta Sekunda. The reason why I think this machshava, because I don't think that I'm the tachlis. What I mean. I think there's a neighborhood. There are people that are living there. And I happen to move into this neighborhood. I realize it's mamish the fakat dinyan. The whole thing's upside down. Davisha created this neighborhood for me to live there. How do I know that? Because the Tachlis HaBriya is Torah Mitzvahs. So the whole block only exists for me. I only move now. This is all Achana. 100 years ago, they paved the wood, the thing. They built a home. They created a neighborhood. Davisha created all those people. But the Tachlis was that there should be a Frumia there. And they should elevate the neighborhood. That was the Tachlis. So not sure that I'm moving to the neighborhood. I'm actually the Balabas here. And everyone is a guest in my place. So you say this is not going to be to think so. No, this is the MS of thought. This is why the Rebbe didn't let people leave any neighborhood. What's shot to leave a neighborhood? Leave a neighborhood means I am here. Why were you here? Because the Abish put you here. Now some new government came up. Not on Chas Shalom, it's dangerous, obviously. I'm talking about it's not Bakum anymore. If you say that the Tachlis HaKavona HaBriya is taken for a year to do Torah Mitzvahs, so why does South Africa exist? The whole reason why there's a South Africa and there's a government and there's people there is so there should be Yidden learning Torah and they're doing Mitzvahs there. So shall the Yid should leave. Understand? Don't think that you're here in someone else's space. The whole space is created for you. But this is changing your mindset from thinking that you're in a tenua, we're moving, you're growing, or that this taka the tachlis, gracious human soul, the shul haTorah, is not a slogan, it's an emes. And if it's an emes and you live this way, what's shot? You're embarrassed to walk in the street with your hat and jacket or with a yarmulke. The old street was created so you should walk in the street with a hat and jacket. I don't fit in, so I feel like maybe I should put on a baseball cap. First of all, between me and you, with that long beard and the devices off, and the baseball hat doesn't fool anybody. Sing English. Oh, with the mold. Chassidish Yid puts on a baseball cap and says, oh, this. Sing English. But they also realize, what do you mean you're embarrassed? What should you embarrass? The whole reason why there's a street is so you should be there. They should be embarrassed that they look like this. If someone walks on the street and doesn't look like you, they should be embarrassed. How come I'm living my tachlis? This is the goyin yakir, the stoltzkeit, to recognize. We say about a day of tachtoinim and the kavona sabriya and the tachlis kavona and the avodas tzaddikim. This can be understood in a very high madrega level in ruchnius, and it has to be understood that way. That we're the tachlis, and we already reached our tachlis, and the shalom should have stopped to be tohiri. That's the emes. We all have kidruchi, and this is the emes metzias who we are. The Alter Rebbe writes in the beginning of Tanya v'soyfer gimel the nida. Mashbim oisit titzadik. So Reb Levik, the Rebbe's father, writes on this up here in Tanya. Says Tanya v'soyf per gimel the nida, in the end of nida, in the end of all the nod golas, you have to recognize. And in the choshech, what kind of choshech? You have to recognize is mashbim oisit titzadik. Mashbim oisit titzadik means Nevi makes us an oath. Mashbim oisit. Mashbim oisit los seveya. Ebisha saturates us, gives us the koyach. That doesn't much be it. Ebisha makes us take an oath. That much be most the tzaddik of Tirasha. Ebisha gave the koyach to be the tzaddik. That's the soif per gimel the nida. The soif, the tachlis. Soif davar a kol nishma l'kim yirei. The soif davar of all the kahelas and all the nigunim. If everything is the much be most the tzaddik that you're talking to tzaddik. This is what the yesoid of the gilu nifla that was revealed in Torah Sachsidus was revealed on a very high level in Torah of Hashem, and then throughout the generations until we reached this generation. And it was a gilu by the Rebbe revealed the atzmistic revealing of lakus in a muchshistic way, in a tachlistic way. To mamish live this way, begashmis, to walk around the tzur of a yid, to walk around what it means to be a yid, to realize that tachlis kavon is takayu. That bishvil niver oilam is not an idea. Bishvil niver oilam is a metzias, azayizus. So taka, like the Rebbe Lublin, the Chosen says that you have to carry two pockets. You have two pockets. One should say bishvil niver oilam, and the other one should say yitush kavmuch. So you don't get too, I just remember a little bit the humility. But b'shvil niver olam, this is the nekuda to remember mi ani yomani. Mi ani yomani. Who am I? To remember who you are. Never once told, I think, Shalom Chaim, Deitch, that told him that the clip of this generation is the mi ani yomani. We don't believe who we are. We don't believe. As you say that in Torah Baal Shem, the Talmud brings it down. Not that the mind of the Gani wants. That the reason why a person's tefillos are not niskabel, the reason why our tefillos are not niskabel, because we don't believe that they should be niskabel. Big late nisht. The Noach was a Iktani Amunahaya. Shat Iktani Amunahaya. Michael Zlotcheva says Iktani Amunah Pshat is because he didn't believe that his tefillah can change it. The Yerusha told him he was going to be a marvel. He was never a mispal. Akin was never a mispal. The Zohar Kodesh says that he was a foolish raya. He's a foolish shepherd. Because he didn't daven. But why didn't he daven? Because Miktani Amona, he didn't believe in himself. He didn't say, me, Noach, I can daven that the Eivisha says I'm going to be Mechor Mes Nedoilam, and me, Noach, is going to be to stop the Chmabu. Miktani Amona, he didn't believe. This is the Moidan Nidl Fonecho. Moidan Nidl Fonecho. The Moidan Nidl. God, this is a sweet story that I once read that there was once a child, 5-year-old, 7-year-old, a child was brought for Rebbe Tzachanan. The Rebbe's mother brought him raw food. Shabbos, but he delivered the food. I guess his father had a store, he delivered the food. And the Rebbe Tzachanan said, I'm going to give you a tip, you know. He said, I don't want the money. But she said, what do you want? He said, I have a question. And I want to know, what is the Rebbe's favorite tefillah? Just don't watch part of the davening. She said, I don't know. You don't know. The next week he came back. And Rebbe Tzachanan told him, I asked my son. And he told me his favorite tefillah is Maidana. The whole Yisoid of that Kuntres is a tefillah Maidani. What's Maidani? Maidani is, it's not from Chazal. It's a Lashon of Yerushalmi that's coasted. It's from Meir Belmachir, from Seder Olam, it's from Tamid Aramak. It's only 500 years old, Maidani. When you say Maidani is a lot of Oymek, but the Kuntres we're talking about. As he finished the Maidani, Shazartim Nishmos, he's saying, Rabba Munasecha. Rabba Munasecha. Hadashim Amkarim, Rabba Munasecha. Rabba Munasecha means, Bashas means Rabba Munasecha, that the Abish has faith. We have faith in the Abish. But Tzaddik writes that Rabba Munasecha means that the Abish has faith in us. Maidani Lufanecha. I'm thanking you, Abishna, that you gave me back my neshama. How do I know? What am I thanking? Because Rabba Munasecha, you believe in me. That's why you gave me back my neshama. I'm waiting on you to have faith in me. Then he says, this is the Rabba Munasecha. The Rabba Munasecha is that we have, that the Abishna has a mood in us. How do you know the Abish has more than us? Because he lets you live. He gave you another day. And you're Bishvila Nivra Olam. The whole Bria is because of you. Kol Olam Kulo Shakol. Also Mitzvah Achras. One Mitzvah changes and tips the whole scale for the better. This is you. This is your Meisim. Achshav Achras, Divar Achras, Meisim Achras. This is the Rabbi Munasecha. The Gadlus HaGadol, Gadlus HaAdam. The Godless Adam, the Nafshistik, on an inner level, the Godless Adam that a person that recognizes the Mashbi Moisati Tzaddik, that this is the Madrega, this is Taku who we are, this is the Oimik of who we are, and the Godless, the Nafsh, the Godless, the Godless, the Tachless, this is the Halicha, in Olam Haba, from the Tzmu of Olam Haba. From the Nekud of Ilum Haba, to walk through this world, to understand that we're talking the Tachlis, and to live it this way. To live in your Tachlis, which is ultimately Yiduch Medan Nidach, is the Madrega Tzadik. So you're going to reach that level of Tzidkus. Ruach Toshav Hashem Nisana, this is the Mahalach that eventually the Neshama is Choyzer to reach a Dagas Tzadik. And so you're living that Tachlis. And also, you're living the Tachlis and how your whole halachah, how you walk in this world. How do you feel about when you walk down the street? How do you feel like when you encounter somebody? You recognize that the kavanah sabriya is in you. The Tachlis kavanah is revealed in you. Then your whole surah changes. Your whole. Way of thinking, your whole way of being, of looking at this world, thinking about yourself, thinking about your challenges, and thinking about your life and your relationships. Everything changes, the whole surah changes. This is the Kavan. This is the Oyer. We're talking about the Oyer. This is the Torah, and this is the Oyer Shem Torah. This is the Marna Dharam says that they were wondering, Sholu, they were wondering, Amav Dharas, why was the world destroyed? It was destroyed, They didn't make a bracha in the Ran rites. They didn't have dvikas in the Oyin Shem Torah. Devil brings out Meshem Balshem. Which bracha didn't they say? Shle Baruch Batoyet Chil. There's a lot of brachas Atoyer. There's three brachas Atoyer. One is the Betzias Atoyer, Tein Shmiksav, Tein Shmol Pem. But it's different brachas. So Balshem says Vaharevna is the bracha that they weren't saying. Vaharevna. There's no Mesikas Atoyer. They were Oisek Batoyer. But they didn't see the Mesikas Atoyer, the sweetness of the Torah, the Oyesh Batoyer. This is Mama Abdu'aretz. We lost the connection with the Mesikas HaTorah. The sweetness, the beauty, the holiness, the majesty. This is the Baruch HaTorah. We want to be Davak in the Oyer. We want to be Davak in the Oyer. The recognition that the Oyer is within us. Davak in Tzadikim, Tzadikim Amos. That allow us to be connected to the light. To be connected to the Oyer HaTorah. To the Surah of the Oyer HaTorah. Not just the information of the Torah. The Sikhs are there. The lawyers are there.